Hello everyone, welcome to Mules of Training by UnoGeeks. In this video, we'll see how to invoke a static Java method from a Mule application with the help of a Java connector. So yes, in some of the integration flows, you might have to invoke a functionality built using a Java methods and classes. And in this video, I'll show you how to exactly do it. Okay, so yeah, let's create a new project. Let's give it a meaningful name. So I'm going to call it as, I'm going to slightly rename it. Static Java method. Because in the next video, we're going to see how to invoke a non-static Java method. And yes, there is a difference in the process. There is a difference in the way you invoke a static Java methods and a non-static Java methods. So let's create a Mule project, give it a meaningful name. Let's add in a HTTP listener to kick off the flow. Configure the connection, HTTP connection with the default values. Use the path, something like a Java demo. Static Java demo. And what I want to do is I want to add in a create a Java class with a method, and I want to invoke the Java method from the Mule flow. So to do that, first let me create a Java method by in this particular folder, source main Java folder. So let me do a right click and new, and I'm going to add a new class, new Java class, and I want to call it as, yeah, the package name is going to be UnoGeeks, and the name is going to be Hello World. Hello World is the name of the class. The name should typically start with a capital letter. And yes, it's a public one, and the superclass is object. Go with the default options and just click on finish. You should see the class getting created without any method. And let's quickly add in a method there, and that too a static method. So, and this static method is going to return a string output. A static indicates that yes, you get back a static return value. Okay, so here you will, and this method is called say hello, and it'll take in name as an input, and all it does is prefixes hello and sends it back as a response. So this is a simple static Java method that will take in name as an input, prefixes hello, and sends it back. And we will see how to invoke this Java method, static Java method to be precise, from the Mule flow. So in real time, the Java methods or the Java functionality that you are invoking, it's going to be pretty complex than this one. But the way you invoke it within the Mule flow doesn't change, whether you have 1,000 lines of code here or a single line of code like this. Okay. So I'm back in my Mule application, and I'll have to add a module. Add module. And you have to add Java to the project. And once you add it, you should see it getting added here as well into the folder structure. And you've got four options available under Java. Okay, so you've got four operations to be precise. You could use invoke static if you want to invoke a static method, and you could use invoke if you want to invoke a non-static method. And yes, if you want to invoke a non-static method, you would have to invoke the constructor first to instantiate, and with that handle you will be able to invoke a non-static method. So we'll see how this works, how a combination of new and invoke can be used to invoke a non-static method in the next video. But in this one, all we want to do is invoke a static Java method, and this is what you need to use to achieve that. Invoke static method, drag and drop it, scroll down, and you need to select the class, and you can search for the class because we already have a class created in the resources folder. So I'm going to search for it. I'll not add a new class. I'll search for it, and I'll search for Hello World. And as I type in, I could see the class that I have created under the UnoGeeks package under in the same project basically. So I pick this up, and you should be seeing the methods from this class in the dropdown. Yeah, since there is only one method, it got selected by default. Say hello, which will take in string input. That's fine. And what I want to do was, remember this Java method takes in name as an input. So what we'll do is, when we invoke this mule flow, we will pass in a name as a query parameter. And let's pass that name query parameter as a value to the static Java method. Okay. And to do that, you can go to the argument section, switch it to expression mode, and you can go into the mapper. And I want to write an expression for this. I want to assign a query parameter that we are going to receive. Yeah, the name query parameter that we're going to receive as input. I want to pass it as input to this particular Java method here. So I can do it by writing a quick data view expression that will look like this. So data view 2.0, and the output type is application Java. And I am assigning a value of the attribute query parameter's name. Okay, so the name query parameter, I'm assigning that as a value to the name. I'm passing that as input to the Java method. This name is nothing but an input parameter that you have on the Java class. So I could have probably used a different variable name here to avoid the confusion, but yeah, that's okay. So yes, so we have added in the mapping now. And I want to send the response back. I just want to probably say that yes, a Java method is invoked successfully. So you can go ahead and set the payload. Okay, you can go ahead and set the payload. That should be fine. And all we are doing in this flow is, yes, it's a HTTP endpoint, which we'll be listening on static Java demo path on port 8081. And it's going to receive name as a query parameter. And yeah, the flow would invoke this Java class. So it's a static Java method that gets invoked here. And we're passing the query parameter name as input to this method, which will get you back a response of hello plus that name, because that is what we are doing in the Java method. And that response will be sent back to the client. Okay, now let's see if it all works fine or not. Now let's start the application. Let's run it. And while the application is getting deployed, let's go to the Postman tool and keep the request ready. Let's copy the path. It's based in the path. So I want to send in a request to that static Java demo path. Let's wait for the application to come up, and we'll send in a request. And we need to pass in a name query parameter, and we could pass in any value there. I'll just pass in UnoGeeks. And what is it that we should get back? We should get back hello UnoGeeks as a response. Okay, so this name that you're passing here will be sent to a method as an input, and that method will prefix hello to that name hello plus gigs, and that entire string would be set as a payload here. Okay, so it's deployed now. Let's go ahead and fire off a request. And what do you see? We've got back hello gigs as a response. So which means yes, the flow is working exactly the way we wanted it to work. And this is how you invoke a static Java method in real time. Okay. So yes, a method in Java in particular, it could be a static method or it could be a non-static method. And in the next video, I'll show you how to invoke a non-static Java method, again, with the help of a Java connector itself from a mule flow. Because the process is going to be slightly different. So please join me in the next video to understand how to do this exactly. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. In case you're interested in MuleSoft training offered by InnoGeeks, please call us on this number or send a WhatsApp message. And in case you need any clarifications or in case you want us to share the course content, just drop us a line on info@InnoGeeks.com. Thank you for watching this, guys.